are on Eldfjall, the second oldest volcano on Heimaey. We just came from Eldfjall, the youngest volcano on the island. Just erupted in 1973.
The higher we climb, the more amazing the views get. And to think that like so much of this is so recent, like all of this wasn't here 50 years ago. It's so crazy, especially when we think in geologic timescales, everything's always, you know, we're trying to conceptualize millions and millions of years.
But these are very new islands, so this is the part of Iceland that's been growing just in the last 20,000 years, and one of the youngest islands in the world is just about 50 years, and it's just behind us over here, Surtsey. So we're talking about the volcanic features, but we're also talking about the larger tectonic features, and about the propagation of the eastern rift zone as it's propagating to the south.
In 1973, there was an eruption on this island, and we know that these rocks were sprayed with seawater as a means of stopping the flow of lava, and I'm just sort of taking some notes on the textures and some of the things I see on the rocks, and we'll make some interpretations later.
Here we're on the beach that's right next to the ferry that we arrived at, and we see a beautiful black sand beach. We're having the students think a little bit about beaches from the perspective of what is the source of the material? Like, not just, oh, it's black sand, it's basalt, but literally, where is it coming from? How is it transported here?
I also think it's so fun that the teachers are exploring this just as much as we are. And so, you know, once we get past like the details and like everyone gathering their observations, it really turns into like this group storytelling effort, which is so fun.
Yeah, there's a big river coming down here and it's kind of formed a little delta, so there's a lot of sand deposited. As we drive inland, we're going to do the same thing with the waterfalls that we'll visit today. So kind of thinking about where they are in a landscape level context.
Collecting data so that then we can interpret that data and learn more about the environment and learn more about the interactions between the environment.
The point is to bring together all of the spheres of Earth system science and tectonics and structural geology and volcanology and beach processes and geothermal processes and marine chemistry and oceanography.
I feel like I'm able to take it all in because we're actually out in the field and we're actually applying our knowledge every second. Because, I mean, Christian will pick up a rock and be like, okay, why is this here? And we just have to figure it out based on what we've learned so far.
So let's just be complete field geologists. I have to name this rock.
It almost characterizes as like a primary source for the Earth. Like you're trying to use these details that you're discovering to piece together a larger historiography of the Earth, which is really interesting.